The shallower water, closer to the shore of the lake, warms more quickly. So it's here that the ice is the most fragile.
The ice is cracking. The ice is definitely cracking. You can see that crack there.
No survival technique can save me here. I've just got to find a way off and move fast. Reaching solid ground is a massive relief.
Back on dry land. That saved me a huge amount of time. Sometimes it is worth taking risks. Sometimes risks pay off. Got the heart pumping anyway.
Crossing the lake saved me precious time, but ahead is a steep climb. The view from the top should reveal how far I've got to go.
The valley swings round to the west too much. That's west. That's the wrong direction. As much as I will it, this is the Altai Mountains. They're not going to change shape for me.
I can't turn back now. My only option is the tougher terrain of the valley wall. But with no climbing equipment, the steep rocks and ice pose a huge risk.
That was lucky. That was very lucky.
The valley I've been following all morning has veered off course. But climbing out of it is just too much of a risk.
And we need to be on the other side of this mountain here. And with all the rockfall and the scree, that is too steep to just go straight over. Somewhat heartbreakingly, I'm thinking that actually maybe the best thing to do is to retrace my steps and go back and over the lip of the valley where I made the decision yesterday to come this way. Okay. I've got to go back.
Sometimes you've got to make tough decisions and cut your losses before it's too late. I've now got to track back and over into a higher valley to the east, but taking on the mountains will require masses of energy, and I've only eaten one small squirrel in the last 3 days.
This scat here that I've just found is full of hairs, which means it must be a carnivore. So that's either fox or wolf. So there are carnivores around here. Definitely carnivores around here.
Wolves can be dangerous, especially in packs. And here, they're the apex predator. The key to survival is to know your place in the natural pecking order.
Birds have been circling for ages. There must be something around here. I suspect there's a carcass somewhere.
This could be a good sign.
That had something in its mouth. That was a raven flying very, very low over that hill. I must be close to a kill site. There is a carcass, and there was a scavenger with his head up on the carcass that just flew away. It's a sheep. It's definitely a sheep. I can smell it from here.
Stinking meat can be eaten safely if cooked well, but I need to know how long it's been dead.
Most likely this is a wolf attack. All of the intestines have been ripped out.
Bacteria will grow on a carcass in days. Eventually, that produces harmful toxins that can lead to botulism. Inspecting the organs for spots and blemishes will show if it's edible.
I think this is a bit of lung. The meat smells, just smells dead. I'm gonna try and get inside the lung in order to see. And I want to see that there's no white spots. See, to me, that looks good.
I reckon it's been dead for less than a week. Animal flesh decays much slower in freezing temperatures, but it will take time to make it safe to eat.
My dilemma now is clearly, is it worth another day of consolidation? The risk is that I use too much time down here and I don't have enough
time to get over the mountains, but if I spend the day processing this sheep and and eating and getting stronger and even making mutton jerky, yes, to carry up over the mountains, I stand a better chance. Let's do it. This is too good an opportunity to pass up. I'm gonna haul the sheep carcass back to the valley camp I stayed at last night. Once I've consolidated, I'll be ready to take on the higher easterly mountain pass.
I have to admit, I didn't expect to be back here.
Crikey, I've got a lot to do really, haven't I?
Okay, the plan is I'm gonna rekindle the fire first of all, then I'm gonna start processing the sheep. I'm gonna see if I can take the hide off it, whether I can take the wool off it or not. And then cut up into joints. I need some of it I'm gonna eat now. Some of it I'm gonna cut into strips and make it into mutton jerky.
Smoking meat over fire removes the moisture and can preserve it for several weeks. To stop my mutton jerky burning to a crisp and losing all its nutrients, I'll have to sit tight here overnight and well into tomorrow. And that's caused a whole new problem.
That's worrying me now is the changing weather. Yesterday, I think I became complacent. Today I can't even see the mountains. It's snowing, or rather sleeting, which is even more dangerous than snowing because it's wet.
My weather window has closed. My rescue team are tracking my progress, and there's concern that conditions are getting much worse. I could be running out of time.
The weather's come in a bit.
It's pretty cold down here. We've had a lot of rain.
And so up over the mountains, I'm sure that's turned to snow.
Over.
Yeah, I know, it's Baltic up here.
I think I'll be fine, quite frankly.
It does look a bit intimidating going up into the mountains, but, you know, that's what the mission is, isn't it?
OK, well, stay safe, stay warm.
Out.
It's cold and it's been raining, so it could be a really difficult day for him tomorrow.
I've got to say, I'm quite worried, Dave.
Yeah, it's a bit of a dodgy one, this one, because, you know, if the weather stays the same, he's going to get wet, and if it hits the snow at the top there and gets cold, that is a real risk.
If we run into a serious health and safety issue, you're going to have to step in.